Hi everyone. Today is Sunday, March 15th, 2015. And some people have been talking about this map here that has come out that's showing about Egypt's plans for the future as they expand and such, and that the new capital will be over in this area. And many people are making the connection that this is actually showing a type of the new world order rising up. When 10 nations come together to betray the USA and betray the Vatican and even go after Israel to rise up with a new world order. It's even going to be done with the secret government of the USA as they all turn their power over to the beast that rises during the end times, a type of antichrist type figure and false prophet with a one world religion and such through there. Well, we're going to go over and take a look at this area right here. This area has not really been built upon here yet, but we map out these things from all around the world. I mean, you look at our channel, you might even have your own hometown mapped out, and we show how all of the earth is as a grid, showing what's coming at the end of the age, showing the new world order actually coming. And we go pretty far out there. We show things like connections with actual, alien-type entities that are actually the fallen angels and the watchers and such. And then we show, things like in the movies and such from the Prometheus movie, where these actual serpents will be upon the world and being put into people. Not kidding. It's part of the mark of the beast at the end times. This is called the Dendera chart. For one thing, we're heading over to Egypt. You should know that from Abraham to Jesus went to Egypt. Moses was taken out from underneath the burdens of Egypt. Even the pyramids are in the Bible, in Isaiah 19:19, which is talking about the burdens of Egypt, and then right here, it talks about the pyramids. In that day shall there be an altar to the Lord in the midst of the land of Egypt, and a pillar at the border thereof to the Lord. The pyramids are in the middle of Egypt and still on the border, because they are right at the middle of the upper and the lower half of Egypt. So it matches this perfectly. That it all represents, it's all about the Lord. And what's underneath the pyramid is considered to be the beast through there. And then the pyramid is just like our burden, like having all of your guilt piled on top of you. We show how God has made all of the universe, and everything's going along like a script to the Bible. Just like God said. This is the map area right here. See New Cairo right there? Cairo. And they're planning New Cairo right about right here. And then to have this open area is going to be the new capital. See that rounded area? Can you see the serpent yet? For one thing. Right here. This represents the beast rising. Do you see him now? The whole world is done like this. Your own town and neighborhood will map these down. See three sixes? 36. There's the serpent coming. Right where the new capital and all will be. Right over here is the pyramids, where we've mapped these out before. And it shows the fifth age of the Bible coming and judgment. Down here is right where the pyramids are, right here. And you can see this person represents the beast, like the church. And then you can see that this angel represents the woman riding the beast, and the one that nobody wants to believe me about that I keep saying. That's the same woman that is caught away with the wings of the eagle when she is burned with fire. And then the fifth age starts and the mark of the beast. She's been granted the wings of the eagle. We have to get all the way up to the Taurus constellation and into what's seen as the Pleiades, the seven angels, the seven churches, the seven candlesticks. It's where all the sweet influence of the universe is bound in one place, right through the Taurus constellation, just like this. From the Dog Star, over Orion, past the V. This is what's coming. This part's coming, the V, the fifth age, like a vampire type thing. Beasts, that's what it means, the age of the beast. And we have to get past that and over into the Pleiades. See, we'd be passed over. That's what that represents. See, God has made all the universe for real. Everything is going perfectly by the script. This is judgment. See, when she's gone, when the woman is gone, this is judgment. right here. See this guy right here? We're going to show that over there on the other side. You can look up all these dates as you wish. I mean, it's a big mystery we're into. You see how this serpent now is up here, like in this big fez hat, and he's controlling the person. And they get this new type of Eucharist, as we've been showing, with the mark of the beast. Do you see the bull is now stamping him in the forehead, and he's having to eat that new Eucharist, as we showed before. See the new Eucharist coming, with this clown coming to trick the world, with the V for the fifth age, the key to open the abyss, just everything as we keep showing, perfectly. And a giant cataclysmic event will happen when this woman is caught away. You see how this woman right here in her wings, we pass over this. This is the church system. Be with Jesus Christ. And we pass over this is the great tribulation coming with that new Eucharist, as we keep showing, that will turn people into animals and beasts, exactly like in that Prometheus movie. You see how, for those that watched my last video about number 9 and the guy going 999 right through there, see the number 9 right there? Do you see that? That's Satan sitting right there and these things coming out of him. There he is. Just like in that Prometheus movie, practically. See how he has that ripped mouth as we keep showing? Number 9. 306, and there's the serpent, the new axis, just like the with the Germans rising up again, as we've been showing. And now they shove that thing into people. This represents the mark of the beast and everything, and it going right into the person right here. This is the whole person. On this side, you can see they're going to get a visor to be made to worship the image of the beast. See this person right here, that false prophet guy or whatever? See like the frog and the snakes coming out of his mouth, turning into a demon, going inside of this person who is worshiping the image of the beast, like that crystal skull. There's the mark of the beast on the person's head, right there. That's what's happening right here. See that visor on the front, and this is his mouth, and they're putting the snake right in there? This is the connection to the dog star. It's being cut, as we've been shown. Remember the dog star? There's no way out then. See, you have to go through the dog star Sirius, past Orion, and pass over this V, that's what's coming, and into the heavenly areas. See, they're cutting it, because inside of there is that little horn holding the new Eucharist right in front of you, right there. Perfect. The little horn sitting right in there holding that new Eucharist and controlling everything. Controlling all of these things as his puppets. See right there? And now you can see this guy with the snake going right in and controlling this guy. See Putin? Putin's missing right now too. Nobody knows where he is. Maybe these types of things are doing something with him. But see how he has the glasses for and everybody following the Pied Piper? The helicopter for the guillotines and such? See the guy back here with the visors on, made to worship the image of the beast? And there's the woman that's caught away with the wings of a great eagle as an 11.5 earthquake or bigger hits the USA. And then all of the rest of the world rises up, even China and such. See that right there? And that's, if you're with Jesus, you'll be caught away. This represents the oil for the wise virgins. And as I keep showing, see the nukes? A giant catastrophic event will be coming when all this happens. And then you can see there, see the snake going into him? This is symbolic of them taking the new Eucharist. That's what the symbolism is, of taking a new type of Eucharist that will have this in there. You're not taking the bread of life anymore. And then up, see the visors? In the Bible it says they're made to worship the image of the beast. Here's the Illuminati, and it shows right here that clown, the number 5 guy, the demon, Satan figure coming to trick the world. And down here they're made to all worship the image of the beast. See, this is an eyeball looking at that. Ebola will spread and the mark of the beast. They blend people with machines. And then there goes the eagle for the woman as the red side rises up and persecutes the blue side. The red side rises up and persecutes the blue side as we all are caught away. It's right in front of us all day long. And it's all meant to happen. Look at that. That's right there. God have mercy. Matching right over here. See this guy with the hat with the snake inside? See him getting a bull stamping him on the forehead? Don't take that mark of the beast. Your soul will be damned. You can see the person right there, just like with this serpent going right in the guy's mouth. It's even on the Dendera chart too, we showed. Right? See Jesus right here? And he's casting down that accuser guy with the hair out to the side. There's the woman ready to meet with that arrow. Do you see the arrow? You know what that arrow means, right? 11.5 earthquake coming when we leave. And then she's granted the wings of the eagle. They get the great sword. The beast out of the sea rises. Now do you see the square box and these snakes that they're putting right in that person's mouth? See, with the beast out of the sea. It's right here done again. See, Jesus as the lion leaves, and it drags up this guy, the little horn. And there's this casket where they're putting the snake into people, or they have to have their heads cut off through there. And then the great stone comes at the very end to destroy everything, because this is all an abomination and a trick. They stole the soul. These people want to steal the soul, leave the snake inside there, and then the snake inside of them basically worships the idol, and they're going to leave. That's what it represents. They're going to try to escape with the soul and leave. It's right there. See that? Jesus, have mercy, huh? Isn't that wild? There's a good snake pick right here, so let's take all that off for a second. Show this one. Oops. Right here. We're just getting ready to stick it right in his head. Show that one. Just like that. See that right by the lines? Look at that. See, that's the hand, and it's sticking the snake right in the head. Just like that. Do the Freemasons have anything showing some of this stuff? Right here on their arch. Because it's all a balance, as I keep showing. We have to go through to the Pleiades. The 69 means like the time of the crossing. It could also mean cancer. But you see right here, we have to, when the woman who is standing on the moon leaves with the wings of an eagle and goes to God, to Jesus Christ, we all leave. And then this beast is released. Do you see him right down here? The Revelation 911 beast, the king of the Illuminati. And then also, the law is back on the world, and the wages of sin are death at that point. That's what that represents. The woman represented grace and mercy leaving and such through there. So there we go. Number 9, verifying that last video I just showed. And that these types of German things are going to be rising back up. Satan. The serpent coming right out of the mouth, going towards the new spot, the new place where they're going to build their new capital. Then the man's head. Eating it. See there, him eating that thing right there? See the snake going up and into his head up there? Then you had this guy over here taking over, cutting off our connection through the dog star. Exactly the same as here, verified. Confess with your mouth, the Lord is Jesus. Believe in your heart, God hath risen him from the dead, and you'll be saved. Hallelujah. Thank you very much, everybody. May God have mercy on us all.